Labas. Dzień dobry Państwu. Dzisiaj jesteśmy z wyjątkowym gościem w naszym kolejnym odcinku Stereotypu. Do you know what is the longest word in Lithuanian? How is Poland in Lithuanian then?
Lenkia.
Lenkia, meaning?
Lenkia. Well, meaning nothing. I mean, there is no...
Thank you very much. What I've also learned, that Lithuanians are very well educated, that you are the one of the most well-educated nations in the world. One of our first nightmares in the school education is to learn poems by heart. Lithuania, my country, taught are like health.
Wow, you made a quite investigation.
Did you like it?
Good.
Powiedziałem labas na początku, ponieważ naszym gościem dzisiaj będzie, mógłbym powiedzieć, że trochę mój przyjaciel, ponieważ zajmujemy się wieloma fajnymi rzeczami i ciekawymi w Parlamencie Europejskim, członek Parlamentu Europejskiego z ogromnym doświadczeniem i pracy w swoim kraju i w Parlamencie Europejskim, Litwin, a więc nasz sąsiad ze wschodniej granicy, Petras Austrewicius. Good morning, Petras.
Good morning, Labas Rytas. Dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry. You speak Polish?
Well, some, because I am originally from, outskirts of Vilnius.
But that supports the stereotype of many Polish people that Vilnius is Polish and only Polish people live in Vilnius.
Well, maybe it was a tendency some decades ago, but now the picture is more, let's say, mixed, and there are more and more, let's say, different nationalities living even in, let's say, in the outskirts of Vilnius.
So maybe we should switch into Polish then.
I wish we could.
But I've heard that this is one of the oldest languages in Europe, and it comes from Sanskrit.
It's a matter of fact that Lithuanian language belongs to the 10 most oldest languages in the world.
Many countries in the world, in the universities, Lithuanian is being studied to learn Sanskrit. And for some of you who don't know what where Sanskrit comes from, it comes from South Asia, and it's a classical language like Latin, Greek, bringing the fundamentals of many other cultures and languages. So. How is Poland in Lithuanian then?
Lenkia.
Lenkia, meaning?
Lenkia. Well, meaning nothing. I mean, there is no...
Thank you very much.
by the words.
Okay.
It's like Germany, for example, Vokietia. Uh-huh. No meaning.
No meaning. Do you know what is the longest word in Lithuanian?
I believe there should be more than 20 or 30 letters in that word.
And there's even more. It's 40.
40.
Okay. Can you read this this word?
This one?
Yes, it's a Lithuanian word. You should know it.
You didn't invent this?
No. It was not invented by me.
First try. Nebeprikiškia kopusta liaujančiuose.
For me, it sounds like you're speaking about cabbage.
Yes, kopustai.
Yes.
Kopustai, yes.
Is it a cabbage?
That's right. Yes, cabbage.
Same in Polish.
Yes. Kiškis, it's a hare.
Ah, okay.
It's a rabbit.
It's not
it's, it's like a rabbit eating leaves of cabbage and not enough, like it sounds like. Oh, thank you. I mean, for this test. Did they pass it?
I don't know, because I have no idea. I found also the longest Polish word,
and
we have longer one, 54 letters, and it's 999-narodowościowego, and it's one word. Speaking about animals, you very much engage in the animals' rights movement.
Yes, I am.
Why is that?
Well, I believe that living in harmony, living on this planet, we should be in peace not just with ourselves. So we have to be able to explain our nature, our ideas, to find a way of cooperation, not fighting with others. I think it's for good of all of us. But again, I mean, we have to respect smaller.
I fully agree with you. If there is a place, one place you would recommend for tourists from abroad to visit in Lithuania?
Typical, probably, stereotype among Polish people is Ostra Brama.
Yeah.
Okay. It's really, it's something special. I mean, to understand the country, I would recommend to go really to nature. Mm-hmm. And to see how people live in a natural environment, still enjoying natural environment. Even some people are able to drink water from small rivers, which is unbelievable in 21st century.
So maybe I found one of these places. It's called Purnuszkes. Purnuszkes. Very inviting name.
Indeed. 20,
Purnuszkes. 26 kilometers from Vilnius. And it's called Geographical Center of the Old Continent. And have you know, been?
Yes.
Does your wife know? Have you been in Purnuszkes?
Another provocation, right? another provocation. I mean, what should you expect from the Polish man? I mean, asking decent Lithuanian in Brussels. All right. Okay,
So, Purnuszkes. Hi, Andrius.
Andrius Kubilus, okay.
Okay. Another one.
From Purnuszkes.
From Purnuszkes.
Well, I mean, that center of Europe was not discovered by us, but by the French... French geographers. So that's why, I mean, blame French scientists for doing this. But it's a very nice place to play golf, by the way.
Ah!
Yeah.
That's Purnuszkes.
In Purnuszkes.
So you have also the greatest number of per habitant hot air balloons. Did you know that?
Yes, I did.
Why
and you know why? Because I think we are privileged, I mean, to have a pretty quiet environment in this regard that, I mean, balloons might fly not disturbing normal plane flights. And Vilnius is only, I believe, European capital where hot air balloons are allowed, I mean, to cross.
Indeed.
And in summertime, I mean, late evening, afternoon, I mean, you might see lots of them. I mean, not just one, dozens.
What I've also learned that Lithuanians are very well educated, that you are one of the most well-educated nations in the world. Did you know that?
Education, I think it's a part of... maybe more recent tendency as, you know, with the 20th century, things have changed for much better. And people got access, I mean, a possibility, economic, financial possibility to let people go to the schools. I think we should still, I mean, keep this on and on and learn even more languages. I mean, what I like that Lithuanians speak foreign languages.
Yes.
I mean, many foreign languages. It's really good.
One of our first nightmares in the school education is to learn poems by heart. And one of them starts like that. And it doesn't bring good publicity for Lithuania. Lithuania, my country, thought are like health. How much for should be prized? Only he can learn who has lost it. Today, the beauty in all its splendor, I see and describe, for I yearn for thee. Do you know where it comes from?
Mickiewicz.
Wow. You see, those are the well-educated Lithuanians. Take an example. Yeah, I fully agree. It's Adam Mickiewicz, bravo. And which poem of his? The most famous epic poem.
Ponastadas.
Bravo! Wow! That's impressive.
Well, I mean, Mickiewicz in Lithuanian language was a very part of our curriculum. I would say poets and philosophers of that time, like Slovacki.
But if there was a literature you would recommend to Polish people to read, to somehow embrace Lithuanian literature more, what would that be?
It's poetry. I think we, as a nation, we have a very high density of poets mm-hmm. per capita, mm-hmm. and really good poets. I wish, I mean, they are translated to other languages. Maybe you heard like Justinas Marcinkevičius. I mean, he is one of the greatest recent poets. But next to him, there are, I'd say, a real plethora of very good poets like this book. I mean, it's Jonas Strelkūnas. Mm-hmm. As you said, it reminds you probably any
a Polish politician,
but he
is not. You can show.
Yeah, but he is not a politician at all. He was a very shy, very decent man from coming from Birzej, northern part, where Radzivilu family had a very big possession. By the way, that book is something because, you know, I'll read you maybe a couple of lines.
I hope it's not offending Poles.
No, I mean, okay, come on. No. I mean,
thank you.
I don't think
thank
I mean
you,
poets are about to defend offend any nation.
I agree.
Už sodo driekės plačios pievos, kur niekas gyvas nei jais. Tenai šienauja miręs tėvas baltais drobiniais marškiniais. Tenai kiekvienas žingsnis žengtas atliepia amžiną tylą. Tenai iškaltas keistas ženklas ant akmenio laukų gale. O kas jį perskaityti bando, netenka žado ir tada išgirsta, kaip dalgius galanda, baltoji pievų brigada. Ir eina vis tolin per lauką, tie vien marškiniai ir basi. Tenai žolė per amžius auga ir nenupjausim jos visi.
Bravo.
From 73. It's a nice poem.
Okay, it's a nice ending for our meeting. So I think to complete it, we should eat a cake. In Poland, we think it's our traditional cake. But in Lithuania, you also take it as your national cake.
Right.
So this is another union of Poland and Lithuania. How is it called in Lithuanian?
Šakotis.
Šakotis.
It's a spiky.
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 In Poland, it's called senkacz.
Senkacz.
Senkacz. Do you like it?
Yes, I do. But it has a lot of energy. I mean, you have to be, you know.
But Europe needs a lot of energy now. Let's eat a cake.
We have to build a better Europe. That's why.
Indeed. Thank you very much, Petras.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you and good luck. And thank you for being with us in this program. Good luck for Lithuania and for you.
Thank you. Viso gero.
How is it?
Viso gero.
Viso gero. Dziękuję bardzo.
Dziękuję.
Thank you very much. Dziękuję wam bardzo i do zobaczenia w kolejnym odcinku Stereotypów.
Wow, you made a quite investigation.
Did you like it?
Good.
Thank you. Hi, Anna.
So we're having
a party. Please take it. No, it's German, she's saying. we think it's Lithuanian and Polish.
Our Lithuanian Polish dialogue went well until the German approached us.
You always destroy it.
Bankuchen, yes, it's Šakotis.
And we call it senkacz. Yeah.
What does it mean in translation?
Nothing
in Polish.
Šakotis.
In us, it's spiky.
It has this
origin,
as you said.
Yeah.
Bankuchen. It's Polish.
It's Bankuchen, yes. Bankuchen.
Okay.
Please take some.
No, I'm fine. I just had breakfast, but it looks very beautiful.
Okay. It's good. I mean,
and
it's,
we usually also put chocolate on top.
And it could be as high as this.
Yes, it's peak.
That's right.
We don't put chocolate on that.
No?
No.
Yeah, that's why the German are always like this, because we put chocolate.
We are poorer.
No, we're crying,
no. No, unfortunately not. It's a pity.
The German that crashed the party.